कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ ए पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर। ए पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर इज प्लेस्ड अलोंग जेड एक्सिस। प्लेट वन एट जेड इज इक्वल टू जीरो, प्लेट टू एट जेड इज इक्वल टू डी। The surface charge density on the surface of the plate 1, it is plus rho s, and the surface charge density on the surface of plate 2, it is minus rho s. The distance between the two plates, it is d, and this parallel plate capacitor is placed along z-axis. The density of the charge, the density of the charge distribution on the surface of plate 1 is plus rho s. The density of the charge on distributed on the surface of plate 2 is minus rho s. The electric field E is directed from plate 1 towards the plate 2 along the positive z direction. The electric field intensity is directed from plate 1 towards the plate 2 along the positive z directions. The work done to move a unit positive charge against the direction of the electric field E is, that is, if a charge is unit positive charge is moved from plate 1 towards the plate 2 against the direction of the electric field E is nothing but the potential difference between the plates, is nothing but the potential difference, that is, between the two plates. So that the potential difference between the two plates V is equal to minus E dot dl, is dl is equal to dx ax plus dy ay plus dz az. Electric field due to surface charge distribution is E is equal to rho s upon 2 epsilon en. Electric field E is equal to rho s upon 2 epsilon en. Epsilon is the dielectric, the constant of the medium between the two plates. En is a unit vector normal to the plates. En is normal to the surface. En is normal to the surface, and electric field E is equal to rho s upon 2 epsilon En. Electric field due to surface charge distributions. Then E1 due to plate 1 is E1 is equal to rho s upon 2 epsilon plus az, that is due to the plate 1. Then electric field E2 due to plate 2 is E2 is equal to minus rho s upon 2 epsilon minus az, that is along the negative z directions. The total electric field due to plate 1 and plate 2 is E is equal to E1 plus E2, rho s upon 2 epsilon plus az, rho s upon 2 epsilon az. Then the total electric field due to the plate 1 and 2 is rho s upon epsilon az. The potential difference between the plates is V is equal to minus integral Z is equal to D to Z is equal to 0 rho s upon epsilon az dot dz az. V is equal to minus integral Z is equal to D to Z is equal to 0 rho s upon epsilon into dz equal to minus rho s upon epsilon Z d is to 0 V is equal to rho s d upon epsilon. Potential difference V is equal to rho s d upon epsilon. The charge stored within the parallel plate capacitor is Q is equal to rho s into A. The charge stored within the parallel plate capacitor is Q is equal to rho s into A. That one, the here A is area of the plates, so that C is equal to Q upon V is equal to rho s into A upon rho s d upon epsilon is equal to epsilon e upon d. That is the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. Here the A is the area of the plates, d is the distance between the plates, and epsilon it is the dielectric constant permittivity of the dielectric material between the two plates. The capacitance of a coaxial cable. A coaxial cable of length L having a charge density rho L with a conductor with a inner conductor with a inner conductor of radius a meters. This one, it is a inner conductor of radius a. Outer conductor of radius b meter is placed. This one, it is a coaxial cable. The length of the cable, it is L. Here the it is this one it is a inner conductor of the coaxial cable. Here it is a outer conductor of the coaxial cables, and radius of inner conductor is a meters and radius of outer conductor is b. The positive the charges are distributed on the surface of along the length of the conductors, and similarly the charges are distributed along the length of the outer conductors, so that here the electric field, then the electric field is directed from inner conductor to the outer conductors. The work done to move a unit positive charge against the direction of electric field from outer conductor to the inner conductor is the potential difference between the two conductors. That is, the work done to move a unit positive charge against the direction of electric field from outer conductor to inner conductor is the potential difference, is the potential difference between the two conductors. So that V is equal to minus integral R is equal to B to R is equal to A is equal to E dot DL. The line integral in cylindrical coordinates, the line integral in cylindrical coordinates is DL is equal to DR AR plus R D pi A pi plus DZ AZ. The line integral in cylindrical coordinates, it is DL is equal to DR AR plus R D pi A pi plus DZ AZ. So that now electric field, it is E, varies in radial directions. Since the electric field, it is varies along the radial directions, so that from that one the electric field due to the infinite line charge distribution is E is equal to rho L upon 2 pi epsilon R AR. From that one, the potential difference between the two conductors is minus integral R is equal to B to R is equal to A rho L upon 2 pi epsilon R AR dot DR AR. V is equal to minus integral R is equal to B to R is equal to A rho L upon 2 pi epsilon R DR. Is equal to rho L upon 2 pi epsilon integral R is equal to V to R is equal to log of A upon B rho L upon 2 pi epsilon log of B upon A. Charge stored between the two conductors of length L is Q is equal to rho L into L. Charge stored between the two conductors of length L is Q is equal to rho L into L. C is equal to Q upon V. It is the capacitance. C is equal to Q is equal to rho L into L, and the V is equal to rho L upon 2 pi epsilon log of B upon A. Here 2 pi epsilon L upon log of B upon A. That is the capacitance of a coaxial cable. L is the length of the coaxial cable, and epsilon it is the dielectric constant of the material between the two conductors. Now let A is equal to, we shall discuss about one of the numericals on the parallel plate capacitors. Let A is equal to 120 cm square, D is equal to 5 mm and epsilon R is equal to 12 for a parallel plate capacitor. Calculate the capacitance after connecting a 40 volt battery across the capacitor. Calculate electric field, flux density, charge stored and the total stored energy. Here C is equal to epsilon E upon D. Epsilon is epsilon naught epsilon R E upon D. Epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12. Epsilon R it is equal to 12. So that then that is a relative permittivity, that is the permittivity of free space. Now area of the plates is 120 centimeter square is equal to 120 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. D, it is 5 millimeters, that is the distance between the plates is 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters, because here all are written in terms of the meters, because A it is given in centimeters area, D it is given in millimeters, so that is also converted to meters. All the parameters are in the meters, so that in same unit 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12 to 12 into 120 into 10 raised to minus 4 upon 5 into 10 raised to minus 3. It is the 0.254 nanofarads. Now, if after connecting a 40 volt battery across the capacitor, calculate E, D, Q and stored energy. E is equal to V upon D. 40 upon 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 is equal to 8 into 10 raised to 3 volt per meters. D is equal to epsilon E, that is flux density, is epsilon naught epsilon R E. 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12 into 12 into 3, D is equal to 0.849 microcoulomb per meter square. Q is equal to C V. C is 0.254 into 10 raised to minus 9 into 40. It is equal to Q is equal to charge stored within between the two plates is 10.16 nanocoulomb. Now energy stored within the parallel plate capacitor is 1 upon 2 CV square. C is capacitance of the plates and V it is the voltage which is applied between the two plates, so that 1 upon 2.254 into 10 raised to minus 9 into 40 square, so that the energy stored between the two plates is within the parallel plate capacitor is 0.203 microjoules. That is the energy stored in the parallel plate capacitor.